LG washing machine, PE error code, which may be showing on your display. This is related to a pressure switch fault. My name's Paul from How to Repair, and in this video I'm going to be showing you not only how to test the pressure switch, explaining the pressure switch system and how it works, and also showing you in the diagnostic sequence how you can test the pressure switch without having to use a multimeter. Okay, LG sell millions of machines, and some are front loaders and some are top loaders, but the principle of the PE error code is exactly the same on all these machines. The machine starts to fill once a program is selected. This water then collects in the drum and starts to rise. At the bottom of the machine, you have a pressure bowl. This is either attached to the sump hose or directly to the drum. As the air inside this pressure bowl pressurizes as the water rises inside the machine, it then sends the pressurized air up to the pressure switch. Now, on old pressure switches, they were mechanical and had a set of points which were either open and shut at a preset level. But the new pressure switches work on sending a frequency level in electric to the circuit board, which is then able to detect, because of the frequency range, what level of water is in the drum. And this is how they're able to accurately measure the water level in machines much better than they used to. It is worth noting, because we are washing at much colder temperatures today, not all the detergent dissolves all the time. And sometimes these pressure bowls can block up with old detergent and other debris that may be in the machine, which has not dissolved and been pumped out. It is also worth noting that these tubes that connect up to the pressure switch, sometimes because the machine actually moves, the drum vibrates, and this hose is constantly flexing. Sometimes you can end up with a perforation hole in this tube, and the tube may be causing a false reading to the pressure switch, and therefore the machine may be overfilling. Using a multimeter, really the only test you can do is across pin 1 and 3. And this will differ because there are many different types of pressure switch according to the different models of the machine. But going across pin 1 and 3, I have got a reading of 20.5 with my meter set on to 200 range. The pressure switch on this one, if I recall correctly when I was testing it, was 21.2. They will differ, but the proper way to test the machine is using the diagnostic sequence. I have done many videos on entering diagnostic mode on different types of machines that you can see in the background, and you'll find them all in the description below or at the playlist at the end of this video. Now, to enter diagnostic mode on this machine, we have to press the on-off button and then button 2 and 4 within 1 second. This will enter diagnostic mode. Diagnostic mode is entered. Now let me quickly explain the frequency levels on this machine. The pressure switch sends the frequency to the circuit board, and then this interprets what's coming from the pressure switch. We have an operating range of 255 with no water in the drum, and on a full level, the maximum level it will allow the machine to fill if there is no faults is 229. When we get to the point in the diagnostic procedure, you will see that it starts filling and the number drops. So let me quickly advance this through the three stages before we get to the fill. One is a rotation, two is a half spin speed with pump, three is the maximum spin speed, four is the actual filling. Now when it comes to fill, you can see it's 255. By the way, when entering diagnostic mode, it is very important that you have no items of clothing in the machine whatsoever. The drum must be empty. Now, as you can see, water is entering the machine and our frequency level is dropping. This says that the pressure switch is communicating with the circuit board. This tells me that the system is good, but we want to check the filling levels. By checking the filling levels, we're understanding that there is no problems with any of the other components as well, because we may be getting false readings. But this number now will continue dropping, and I'll let it fast forward until it gets to 229, and the water level should be somewhere around here. Okay, as you can see, the level now has got to 231. And when this gets to 229, it will shut the water off. It may come back on as it just equalizes the correct level in the machine to the frequency that's coming from the pressure switch. Now the machine has finished filling to the maximum level that the program allows with this machine, which is the operating range of 229. The machine now has stopped the water valves from letting any water into the machine. if you were doing a diagnostic test, you may have a PE error code coming up at this point if it was not getting a reading. Because if this is not sending the frequency reading to the circuit board, this is basically where the fault lies with the part itself. But if you have a problem with the machine overfilling or underfilling, then it may be a problem with either the pipe, the pressure bowl, or the last thing that we're going to look at now, which is wiring connections and checking the wiring harness. Okay, the last thing we'll quickly discuss is checking the wiring to the actual circuit board. Now, of course, wiring looms are encapsulated on most occasions with the LG, and it's very hard to actually follow the wire all the way back. But we can use the color coding system that's on here, and we have a purple, a larger white wire, and an orange wire. And basically, when I was looking at the circuit board, we did have an orange and white here, but we didn't have a large white. The larger white was going to that one. So taking the plug off, checking each individual wire, setting the meter onto continuity, and we're checking the orange wire, and as you can see, we've got perfect continuity. Do that with all the wires, that will eliminate that problem. It is possible it could be the circuit board, but it would be a very rare fault for a PE error code to be caused by the circuit board. Predominantly it will be the actual pressure switch that's faulty. But if you do need a circuit board, I'll give you a tip. You can find them on eBay using the part number which is written on there, but do make sure it fits your model of machine, because you may have different wash cycles, because programs are sometimes programmed in specific ways for specific models of machine. And there we go, we'll just let the machine empty now, and as you'll see, it's 230. It starts to empty, the water's emptying from the machine, and this will now go all the way back up to 255, meaning it's telling the machine it's empty of water. And there we go, we've got back to the original level of 255. If you need any pressure switches, the link is in the description below. And also, if you want to support the website, you can always click on the Buy Paula Beer page to donate to the website to support us. Thank you very much indeed for watching this video, and don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.